And now to the man assuming that role, President-Elect Troy Brown sits down with us. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
I want to get started with something that your predecessor said about you as you are taking the helm. He said, quote, Troy Brown brings thoughtful leadership at a critical time for ICMA. First off, what does it mean to you to have that high praise?
Well, Jim's an amazing president. He led the association through an incredibly difficult time. And now is the opportunity to really think big and think about the future and where it puts us at this moment in time as we move this association forward. So that does require some difficult conversations as we reset and restart. But you also have to be thoughtful, as Jim mentioned, and it means very high praise coming from someone like Jim.
So as we look ahead to the future of ICMA, what do you envision?
You know, I envision, first of all, I'm excited about the opportunity to restart. This is a very unique moment in time for ICMA. So we really have the opportunity to rethink everything that we do from the ground up. And I'm looking forward to what that means for our membership, what that means for our member dues structure, what that means for our international members and our program offerings as well. So I'm looking forward to being part of that journey and part of that discussion as we retool the organization. I'm looking forward to it.
What does an ICMA look like under a Troy Brown presidency?
Well, I can tell you that it definitely doesn't look as it looked last year. I think under a Troy Brown presidency, one of the things I really want to do is try and reconnect with the members. One of the benefits of being an ICMA member is having a close connection with the association. And because of the pandemic, we really missed a lot of that. And that was one of the things that we experienced as a loss. So I want to get back out into the States. I want to get back out with the members and sit down and talk with them and understand what their issues are and help them, you know, get the resources that they need and get the feedback that we need to move the association forward.
And finally, before I let you go, what do you anticipate to possibly be your biggest challenge and your greatest opportunity?
You know, I think the biggest challenge that we're going to have to face is, what is our due structure? You know, we have been going through a conversation over the past several months on the future of the due structure. Is it aligned with our mission to invite and bring in all the members from across the association? That's going to be a lift. That's certainly a need that we have coming out of the pandemic and the economic recession. So I'm excited about that. One of the things that I'm really excited about is, how do we provide programs and offerings moving forward? You know, we learned a lot through the loss that we experienced through the pandemic. One of the things that we learned is, people still need ICMA there as a resource, and they can get it now on their own terms. You know, maybe we do hybrid learning, maybe we do in-person learning, but I'm excited about putting the infrastructure in place to be able to use that structure moving forward well beyond the pandemic. So we're certainly going to take a step. We're not going to get the whole bite, but I'm excited about the future.
A lot to look forward to. Congratulations on your new role. Thank you.